So who's the boss who retired from Microsoft with a nest egg worth billions? Rita Braver has the answer.
The magazines say this guy has $41 billion.
That's what the magazines say.
I cannot fathom that. I think most people can't.
I can't. What does it mean? What does it mean to my lifestyle? I could buy the LA Clippers.
Do we have any Clipper fans here?
And so in 2014, Steve Ballmer, who at age 63 ranks as one of the wealthiest people in the world,
where to go?
Did just that.
Work defense, work!
But the team has yet to win a championship.
Well, I think our team plays with a lot of grit, a lot of excitement, a lot of toughness, hardcore. You know,
kind
Lakers.
Swimming against the stream idea.
Yeah, exactly.
Ballmer is used to swimming against the stream. He grew up in Detroit, his dad a Swiss immigrant who never finished high school. Steve Ballmer took a risk in 1980 and dropped out of business school to help an old friend from Harvard undergrad with his fledgling software company, Microsoft. The friend, of course, was Bill Gates.
I wanted to work in a business that seemed to be rapidly changing because I have a little bit of ADD, if you will, in my personality. And I wanted to work for somebody who I believed was really smart.
Ballmer became Microsoft's 30th employee, put in charge of sales and business development.
Where do you want to go today? Because Microsoft software can really help you get there.
Ballmer struck a shrewd deal that ultimately gave him almost 9% of the company. It was the dawn of the personal computer era. As Microsoft launched revolutionary operating systems like Windows 95. In 2000, Gates named Ballmer to replace him as CEO, and Ballmer's high-spirited antics at company meetings are still legendary.
Developers, 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 developers.
As CEO, Ballmer helped make Microsoft one of the leaders in selling software systems to large corporations. But he acknowledges he was late in steering Microsoft into the search and smartphone markets. Steve Ballmer retired in 2014, leaving in his own distinctive way.
You've made this the time of my life.
But figuring out what to do after Microsoft was not so easy for Ballmer.
I went a little manic. I played 100 rounds of golf. As crazy as that, I was good too at that time. But I was manic. And then after a year, it's sort of, okay, breathe. And that's when I really took back control of my time.
Time is a prime commodity for Ballmer, who for years has been keeping spreadsheets to track how he spends every minute from 9 to 5.
It shows the number of hours a year I want to spend, 366 hours in the year on the Clippers.
But his wife of 29 years, Connie Ballmer, thought he should start spending more time on philanthropy. She'd been directing the couple's efforts, aimed primarily at creating opportunity for kids in need. And the Ballmers rank among the nation's most charitable donors.
So Steve said, he was being a little controversial, he said, oh, philanthropy, why do we need to do philanthropy? Why don't we let the government just give away the money and take care of these people?
Even though you've been doing it all along.
I said, really? And of course I challenged that, which got him thinking, hey, I wonder what the government spends its money on. I'm gonna find out. And when he couldn't find out immediately,
that's where the idea of USA Facts was born.
Access to information is key to understand what's really driving the direction of our country.
USA Facts is a free, nonpartisan website that's trying to provide one-stop access to all government data.
Any number that the government collects, you're trying to
put it at their fingertips.
Exactly. You want to see what the population looks like that we're serving. Demographics, family, population.
Launched just 2 years ago and headquartered outside Seattle near Ballmer's home, he has poured about $30 million into USA Facts so far.
In 1980, we spent just under $3,000 per person on health care as a society. Today, we're spending just under $10,000 per person. Inflation adjusted, we are spending over three times as much.
And you can see how the proportion of people in each state have changed over the years.
Ballmer hired a team of young computer hotshots to help unearth information, like how much different income groups pay in taxes.
You're obviously in the top 1% of the top 1%. Do you feel like people at that level are paying enough taxes?
I am nonpartisan.
Right.
Do I feel like I have obligation to give back to society? I'd say yes. Society has to decide on policy. If the policy is, let's tax the more affluent people more, okay. I'm good with it.
Ballmer says the whole point of USA Facts is to help voters make decisions. But how to respond when politicians assert they have better facts and the ones the government provides.
If you think any politician is using numbers that aren't accurate, boom, call them out. Ball from the All-Star game.
As for Steve Ballmer, he has a personal interest in the number one.
Are there some big things you still want to do?
The only thing I can really, really, really point to that I'd like to do but haven't done is be in a parade with an NBA championship. Man, I want to make progress on everything else, but to hold that trophy and have it be ours? Yeah, that'd be on my list.